Users worry about battery constantly, and that means that we, as developers, should constantly be vigilant about battery use. So we decided to build that vigilance into the framework. In Marshmallow, we introduced Doze, because at some point, the user will probably place their device on a coffee table or nightstand. This means they've turned the screen off, the device isn't plugged in, but it is stationary. So when they pick the device up again off of that table, their battery should not have magically dropped by 30%. And that's why Android will defer background jobs and syncs, as well as alarms and Wi-Fi scans, until a scheduled maintenance window, so that all background activity happens in one batch. By having these specific maintenance windows, we can extend the battery quite significantly. But now, we have extended Doze for a more common use case, leaving your phone in your pocket. When the screen is off, after a short while, a light version of Doze will trigger with a smaller set of restrictions, and we will have regular maintenance windows during this time. But all of our advice still applies here. If you've done the work to account for Doze and App Standby in Marshmallow, you won't need to do anything extra now. Note that this does not replace Doze as it was in Marshmallow. If the device becomes stationary for some period of time, the full set of restrictions will apply again. So it helps to understand what the distinction is. The lighter Doze mode has maintenance windows that trigger on shorter intervals so that your app can be ready when the user returns to using their device. And wake locks, GPS, Wi-Fi scans, and alarms all work normally in the lighter mode. Here, we are focusing on background syncs and jobs and, more generally, network access, because these are both large drains on the battery while being the most flexible things to defer and optimize when a user is out and about. As expected though, a high priority GCM message is still the best way to deliver time critical information to your app. When you do, your app gets a brief reprieve to use the network and see what's up. This allows your server to be confident that the important things reach the user. And of course, any foreground service will continue to work regardless of battery optimizations. So whether the device is stationary or not, if that screen has been turned off for a while, we intend to honor the fact that the user isn't engaged with the device, and that is an opportunity to conserve power. So test your app to be sure it works how you expect it to, and consider tweaking a few behaviors so that you can continue to build better apps.